Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I formally declare open a special council meeting Thursday the 24th of March 2022, time being 6 p.m. and I welcome you all here, noting that this meeting is live streamed and across to our community as well. So welcome to all of you who are in the council chamber or otherwise located across the great state of Western Australia. I acknowledge the Whadjuk people of the Noongar Nation, who are the traditional custodians of the land on which we are gathered, and I pay respect to the elders past, present and emerging, and extend that respect to Indigenous Australians with us in the council chamber or online. And noting that tonight's meeting will be conducted in two parts. Part A will consider item 10.1 of the Audit, Risk and Compliance Committee members' appointment. At the conclusion of part item 10.1, this council special council meeting will adjourn to enable the Audit, Risk and Compliance Committee meeting to be conducted, at which time we will then, at the conclusion of that, reconvene at part B, as we're calling it, of the special council meeting to take account of the outcomes of that particular Audit, Risk and Compliance Committee meeting itself. So noting that elected members in the chamber will be voting using the electronic system here. Members online will be voting by way of show of hands. And if you'd like to speak, those particularly online, please raise your hand and we'll take account of that. And please keep your cameras on at all times so that we're aware that everybody's locked into the meeting itself and able to participate, and have your microphones turned off unless you are speaking. Having said all of that, we'll move through to agenda item 3, which is the disclaimer, which I'll now read. Members of the public who attend council meetings should not act immediately on anything they hear at the meetings without first seeking clarification of council's position. Persons are advised to wait for written advice from the council prior to taking action on any matter that they may have before council. Agenda item 4, which is acknowledgement of receipt of written declarations of financial interest and conflict. There's been no declarations received at this point. Are there any declarations at all? No declarations. Thank you. Agenda item 5, which is apologies and leave of absence. We have a leave of absence for Councillor Tablanche. Agenda item 6, which is public question time. We have no public questions. And we have nothing that's come in online. Agenda item 6 is deputations, which is nil. Agenda item 7 is declaration by members who have not given due consideration to matters contained in the business paper presented before the meeting. Are there any declarations to be made by members? No, thank you. Agenda item 8 is the purpose of the meeting. As I said at the beginning, part A is to nominate an elected member or members to the Audit, Risk and Compliance Committee, noting that the meeting will be adjourned and reconvened at the conclusion of the Audit, Risk and Compliance Committee meeting. And then part B, which is for the special council meeting to adopt the compliance audit return for the period of 1st of January to the 31st of December 2021, for it to be submitted to the Department of Local Government, Sport and Cultural Industries by the statutory time frame of the 31st of March 2022, as required by Regulation 14 and 15 of the Local Government in brackets audit, close of brackets, Regulation 1996 as amended. I'm just moving through now to agenda item 10.1, which is Audit, Risk and Compliance Committee membership appointment. And at this point we have one nomination to the committee, which has been received from Councillor Cork. Are there any other nominations? No. Councillor Siparovic?
Yeah, if I can, I would like to move to nominate myself as a deputy for the committee, not as a full member. Just a deputy in case we ever have issues with not having a quorum in the future.
Sorry, Councillor Elliott?
I would have thought that I'm not sure the terms of reference allow for a deputy, do they? In which case, Councillor Siparovic would need to be a member.
Thank you, Councillor Allen. We'll just check with Mr. Broome.
It's a matter for Council to determine. So Council is free to appoint deputies if it so chooses. The issue, obviously, we had at the committee meeting related to, there was a decision of Council at that point. So Council, in adopting and appointing a deputy, that becomes then the practice.
Thank you, Mr. Broome. We have a recommendation there. Is someone prepared to move that, please? And taking into account Councillor Siparovic. Councillor Siparovic, was it? Yeah, Councillor Siparovic.
I don't feel I need to speak on the matter, but I'm willing to move it.
So you need to read it out?
Okay, so the recommendation that Council notes Mayor Howlett's resignation from the Audit, Risk and Compliance Committee effective 17th of March 2022 and appoints Councillor Cork as a member of the Audit, Risk and Compliance Committee, and part three appoints Councillor Siparovic as a deputy to the Audit, Risk and Compliance Committee.
Thank you, Councillor Siparovic. Do we have a seconder for that, please? Councillor Kirkwood, thank you. And Councillor Siparovic, did you want to put a reason through on that? No? Okay. Thank you. So does anyone wish to speak against that recommendation? Everyone clear of what it stated? Okay, then if no one wishes to speak against, we'll just call for the... Or Councillor Duan?
So, just a quick question. So the membership that was already there, like if a councillor was member previously, that continues, is that right?
Correct, yes, Councillor Duan.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
If there's no further questions at all, we'll ask for the voting button and for those online to raise their hand if you're in favour. Declare that carried 7-0. Is it? 8-0, thank you. So at this point in time, we'll look at adjourning this particular meeting to allow the audit, Risk and Compliance Committee to meet and to provide an outcome to enable us to move to part B of this particular special council meeting. And we're adjourning at 6:09 p.m.